Welcome everyone. Today I wanted to do a video about a strategy that you can use in Daedalus for the upcoming incentivized testnet. This video is also applicable for those who are not staking in the incentivized testnet but wish to stake in the future. But first we're going to focus on those that are staking within the incentivized testnet. So if you go to Daedalus, you can create new wallets, which is very helpful, especially in the future. And whether or not you hold a lot of ADA or what you think is a lot of ADA, here on this channel, we anticipate that the price of ADA will increase in the future, given the utility and given that the project hits its milestones. So while it may not seem feasible to create a budget strategy now for most, it is something to think about if you're in this project long term. So you can go to Daedalus and you can create a new wallet relatively easily. And the reason why I made this video today is because there have been some new news announcements that are saying that you will not be able to split up your wallet within the incentivized testnet. So say you hold 1,000 ADA in a wallet, we'll just go to the Phil PA wallet where we have 260 ADA here. I cannot go in the incentivized testnet and delegate 130 ADA to pool A and 130 ADA to pool B. That feature is going to be introduced later, probably within the mainnet stage, but you have to go all in with a wallet into a particular pool when you're delegating in the incentivized testnet. So if you want to delegate to multiple pools, you're going to have to start splitting up your wallets now. The snapshot is happening this month. There are going to be two snapshots. So if you want to delegate to multiple pools, please split up your wallets now. But the purpose of this video is to talk about strategies, because as we progress, we're talking about 6 months, a year, 2 years, 3 years from now, you're going to be receiving rewards for the ADA that you delegate to certain pools. So if that pool is a reliable pool, you'll be receiving rewards. One strategy is to create a budget. This is very analogous to budgets in the typical fiat world, where you allocate money to certain categories in your life. So you can do the same for ADA, or use Daedalus as a sort of budgeting tool. So you're using certain ADA wallets as revenue streams for certain projects that you have in your life. And as you can see, I just created a category for entertainment. I just created a category for housing. So should you decide in the future you're going to be spending your money on entertainment or anything of that sort of nature, maybe this wallet right here and its rewards are solely dedicated to entertainment. This wallet right here, maybe it's dedicated to your housing, whether that be your rental income or your mortgage or whatever income or expenses that you have relating to housing. Then you have insurance, you know, your health insurance and all the other vehicle insurances that you have. Maybe that category is just for insurance. Maybe there's a category just for your vehicle. Maybe there's a category for your food every week or every month. And maybe there's a category for future investments if you want to reallocate to different blockchain projects in the future, or just completely use these assets to invest in alternative classes of investments like real estate or stocks or any other investments that may allow you to grow your wealth in the future. So this is very easy. All you have to do is go to add wallet, create your new wallet, and create a category. So if you want to create this category for your, let's put a moon wallet, and we create the personal wallet, click create personal wallet. You're going to click this button, and once it hits continue, it's going to provide you your seed phrase. And it's very easy to delete these wallets right after they're completed. Once again, I'm showing you the seed phrase, but I will not be using this wallet. I will delete this wallet. I'm not even going to create this wallet. So I'm going to exit here, and I'll show you how to delete the wallet. So if you don't need a certain wallet, or you've emptied out that particular wallet, you can just go here. You can go to more. You can go to settings. You can go to delete wallet, click this button right here. I'm going to put the name of the wallet here. So this is food. We're going to wait 1 second, and then we're going to hit delete, and it's gone. It's as easy as that. For the individuals that are interested in staking in the incentivized testnet and you want to delegate to multiple pools, you're going to have multiple wallets, because the feature to split ADA within a single wallet to multiple different pools will not be available until mainnet. So let's see. We would have to have, let's see. So if there was ADA in entertainment wallet or housing wallet or insurance wallet or future investment wallet, we'd have to each delegate that to a pool and go all in. So that's a quick reminder. Now let's shift over to the people that are not going to be joining us for the incentivized testnet, but will start staking when the mainnet releases because of fears of moving their funds off of the hardware wallet support. This is also for you. You can create new wallets. You can create your budget, your cryptocurrency budget in the future, and allow yourself to understand that this wallet is allocated maybe for family. This wallet is allocated for gifts and donations. This wallet is allocated for pets, or this wallet is dedicated for hobbies, any expenses that you have in life. Start figuring out where you spend money in the traditional world with traditional fiat, and then you can convert that or create cryptocurrency categories or wallets that will align with those categories in the future. So this is a very effective strategy, especially if you see yourself long-term. Create multiple wallets and have multiple purpose wallets for different things. You can have your long-term HODL wallet and you can have your short-term sell wallet with different milestones for each wallet. Say you're looking for a particular price and you're going to sell 20, 30, 40% of your ADA holdings, then have a wallet for that. If you are looking for a long-term, I'm going to hold this for 5-10 years, or I'm going to give this to someone that I care about in a very long period of time, have a wallet for that. Have a wallet for spending ADA on a day-to-day basis. As we grow this ecosystem, we just got added to Travala. It's no Travelocity, but it is a website that you can pay with you using ADA for hotels and various different travel expenses. There are going to be more stores and places where you can use your ADA to shop and spend. And once again, I'm not telling anyone to spend their ADA or anything like that. You need to find yourself a CPA. CPAs are great. I have a CPA. So regarding if I get any questions about taxable events, you need to contact your CPA. I am not a financial advisor. This was a video just helping those create categories in Daedalus and have a cryptocurrency strategy for long-term and short-term investing. Tell me what you think. Let me know what categories you split your wallets into, and let me know what you are planning on spending your ADA on in the future, or what you're planning for. It's interesting to hear. Maybe we can open up a dialogue and see exactly where everyone is strategy-wise. I hope everyone has a wonderful day and a wonderful week, and until the next video, thank you.